Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. I want to emphasize that my perspective is coming from one with type 2 and not type 1 diabetes. Our channel is primarily for those with type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes. Today, I want to answer the question, my father has diabetes, should I be screened for prediabetes on a regular basis? After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you'll find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning and tips and tricks, and there are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. Diabetes is a complex condition. Several factors must come together for you to develop type 2. For example, obesity and a sedentary lifestyle play a role, but genetics can also influence whether you'll get this disease. There really needs to be more research in the field of prediabetes, but there seems to be a link, especially given the fact that many with prediabetes develop type 2 within 10 years. Now, this article is based on genetic links with type 2 simply because the research isn't extensive enough for prediabetes. But I honestly feel the comparisons are closely related and can be extrapolated. Now, if you've been diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, there's a good chance that you're not the first person with diabetes in your family. According to the American Diabetes Association, your risk of developing type 2 diabetes is 1 in 7 if one of your parents was diagnosed before the age of 50, 1 in 13 if one of your parents was diagnosed after the age of 50, 1 in 2 if both your parents have diabetes. Several gene mutations have been linked to the development of type 2. These gene mutations can interact with the environment and each other to further increase your risk. Now, the role of genetics in type 2 diabetes, well, it's there, and it's also an environmental factor. Scientists have linked several gene mutations to a higher risk of diabetes. Not everyone who carries a mutation will get diabetes, but many people with diabetes do have one or more of these mutations. And it can be very difficult to separate genetic risk from environmental risks. The latter is often influenced by your family members. For example, parents with healthy eating habits are likely to pass them on to the next generation. On the other hand, genetics play a big part in determining weight. Sometimes behaviors can't take all the blame. Studies of twins suggest that type 2 diabetes might be linked to genetics. These studies were complicated by the environmental influences that also affect type 2 risks. To date, numerous mutations have been shown to affect type 2 diabetes risk. The contribution of each gene is generally small, however, each additional mutation you have seems to increase that risk. In general, mutations in any gene involved in controlling glucose levels can increase your risk of type 2 diabetes. These include genes that control the production of glucose, the production and regulation of insulin, how glucose levels are sensed in the body. Genes associated with type 2 diabetes include TCF7L2, which affects insulin secretion and glucose production, ABCC8, which helps regulate insulin, CAPN10, which is associated with type 2 diabetes risk in Mexican Americans, GLUT2, which helps move glucose into the pancreas, the GCGR, a glucagon hormone involved in glucose regulation. Now, tests are available for some of the gene mutations associated with type 2. The increased risk for any mutation is small, however. Other factors are far more accurate predictors of whether you'll develop type 2 diabetes, including your BMI, your family history, high blood pressure, high triglyceride and cholesterol levels, history of gestational diabetes, and being a certain ethnicity, such as Hispanic, African American, or Asian American. Now, we do have some tips for prevention. The interaction between genetics and the environment make it difficult to identify a definite cause of type 2. That doesn't mean you can't reduce your risk through changing your habits. A large study of people at high risk for diabetes suggests that weight loss and increased physical activity can prevent or delay type 2, according to the Diabetes Prevention Program. Here are some things you can do to start today. And we have many videos on this already, but start an exercise program. Slowly add physical activity into your daily routine. For example, take the stairs instead of the elevator. Park further away from the building entrances. You can also try going for a walk during lunch. Once you're ready, you can start adding lightweight training and other cardiovascular activities. Your aim? 30 minutes of exercise each day, 5 days a week. You also need to eat healthier. It can be hard to avoid extra carbohydrates and calories when you're dining out. Cooking your own meals is the easiest way to make healthier choices. You can ease yourself into it too. Start by planning your lunches for the week. Once you're comfortable with that, you can plan out additional meals. Choose healthy snacks. Try things like carrot sticks instead of that candy bar. Apples or other fruits. Fruits are a wonderful source of fiber in most cases and are great healthy snacks. A handful of nuts. Air-popped popcorn. Don't add a lot of salt or butter. And eating crackers and cheese. Now, knowing your risk for type 2 diabetes can help you make changes to prevent developing the condition. Tell your doctor about your family history. They can decide if genetic testing is right for you. They can also help you reduce your risk through lifestyle changes. Your doctor may also want to regularly schedule your glucose levels. Check those. That can help them detect any blood sugar abnormality or warning signs for type 2 earlier. Earlier treatment can be a positive impact on your outlook. Now, just because your father had diabetes, should you be screened for diabetes on a regular basis or pre-diabetes? Well, that's really up to you. There seems to be a genetic link. So talk to your healthcare provider, see what they have to say about at least yearly blood glucose screenings and A1C tests for you. Don't forget to get my new ebook and please subscribe to our channel so that we can bring you many more videos like this one in the future. I want to thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.